Hello, darling.
Hello, Daddy.
Hello, Daddy.
How do you like it?
Bless you.
Did you bring the wreath? Yes, Daddy, did you bring the Christmas wreath?
What wreath?
Well, the Merry Christmas wreath for the window.
Oh, I left it at the office.
Is it snowing?
Yeah, it just started.
Well, where's your coat and hat?
I left them at the office.
What's the matter?
Nothing's the matter. Everything's all right.
George slumps into an armchair and lifts little Tommy onto his lap. Mary and Pete go back over to the Christmas tree and continue decorating it. Tommy is covering his face with a Santa mask and making funny noises at George.
Go on, Pete. You're a big boy. You can put the star up. Way up at the top. That's it.
There it is.
Fill in that little bare spot right there. That's it.
George pulls little Tommy into his chest desperately.
Isn't it wonderful about Harry? We're famous, George. I'll bet I had 50 calls today about the parade, the banquet. Your mother's so excited, she...
As Tommy jumps down from George's lap, Mary looks over and realizes that something is seriously wrong with George. Tommy starts putting tinsel on top of his daddy's head as George tries to pull himself together.
Must you keep playing that?
I have to practice it for the party tonight, Daddy.
Mom said we could stay up till midnight and sing Christmas carols.
Can you sing, Daddy?
Better hurry and shave. The families will be here soon.
Families? I don't want the families over here.
Come out in the kitchen with me while I finish dinner.
George and Mary begin walking towards the kitchen, with Tommy hanging on to George's coattails, pulling at him.
Excuse me!
Have a hectic day.
Ah, yeah, another big red-letter day for the Baileys.
Daddy, the Browns next door have a new car. You should see it.
What's the matter with our car? Isn't it good enough for you?
Yes, Daddy.
Excuse me!
Excuse you for what?
I burped.
All right, Tommy, you're excused. Now go on upstairs and see if little Susu wants anything.
Mary turns to the stove and takes the roast out of the oven.
Zozo, what's the matter with Zozo?
Oh, she's got a cold. She's in bed. Caught it coming home from school. They gave her a flower for a prize, and she didn't want to crush it, so she didn't button up her coat.
What is it, a sore throat or what?
Just a cold. The doctor says it's nothing serious.
A doctor? Was a doctor here?
Well, yes, I called him right away. He says it's nothing to worry about.
Is she running a temperature, or what is it?
Just a teensy one, 99.6. She'll be all right.
Gosh, it's this old house. I don't know why we don't all have pneumonia. This drafty old barn of a place. Might as well be living in a refrigerator. Why do we have to live here in the first place and stay around this measly, crummy old town?
George, what's wrong?
Wrong? Everything's wrong. You call this a happy family? Why do we have to have all these kids?
Dad, how do you spell Frankenstein?
I don't know. Ask your mother.
Where are you going?
Going up to see Zozo.
He told me to write a play for tomorrow.
George starts up the stairs. The knob on the banister once again comes off in his hand, and for a moment, he has an impulse to hurl it into the living room. Then, he replaces the knob and goes on up the stairs.
F-R-A-N. K-I-N.
Hi, Daddy.
Well, what happened to you?
I want a flower.
Oh, wait now. Where do you think you're going?
Want to give my flower a drink.
All right. Give Daddy the flower. I'll give it a drink.
Zuzu shakes her head and presses the flower to her. No, a few petals fall off. She picks them up.
Look, Daddy! Paste it!
Yeah, all right. All right, I'll paste this together here.
Zuzu hands him the fallen petals and the flower. He turns his back to her, pretending to be tinkering with the flower. He sticks the fallen petals into his watch pocket, rearranges the flower, and then turns back to Zuzu.
There it is, good as new. Now give the flower a drink. Now will you do something for me?
What?
Will you try to get some sleep?
I'm not sleepy. I went to look at my flower.
I know, but you just go to sleep, and then you can dream about it, and it'll be a whole garden.
It will.
Uh-huh.
Zuzu continues to look over at the flower. George places his hand on her forehead and is concerned as he can feel that she still has a temperature.
Telephone! I'll get it.
George comes back down the stairs. In the background, Tommy is playing with a toy vacuum cleaner, adding to the noisy environment.
Hello? Yes, this is Mrs. Bailey.
Oh, thank you, Mrs. Welch. I'm sure she'll be all right. The doctor says she ought to be out of bed in time to have her Christmas dinner.
Is that Zuzu's teacher?
Yes.
Let me speak to her. Hello. Hello, Mrs. Welch? Yeah, this is George Bailey. I'm Zuzu's father. Say, what kind of a teacher are you anyway? What do you mean sending her home like that half naked? Do you realize she'll probably end up with pneumonia on account of you?
George!
Is this the sort of thing we pay taxes for? To have teachers like you silly, stupid, careless people who send our kids home without any clothes on? You know, maybe my kids aren't the best dressed kids in town. Maybe they don't have any decent clothes. Ah, oh, the stupid.
Hello, Mrs. Welch? I want to apologize. Hello? Hello? She's hung up.
Oh, hang her up. What's that? Hello? Who's this? Oh, Mr. Welch. Okay, that's fine, Mr. Welch. Give me a chance to tell you what I really think of your wife.
George!
Will you get out and let me handle this? Hello? Hello? What? Oh, you will, huh? Okay, Mr. Welch, anytime you think you're man enough, you... Hello? Any...
Dad, how do you spell hallelujah?
How should I know? What do you think I am, a dictionary? Tommy, stop that! Stop it! Janie, haven't you learned that silly tune yet? You play it over and over again. Now stop it! Stop it!
George turns to his workbench of model buildings and bridges.
Sorry, Mary. Janie, I'm sorry. I didn't mean that. You go on and practice. Pete, I owe you an apology too now. I'm sorry. What do you want to know now?
Nothing, Daddy.
What's the matter with everybody? Janie, go on. I told you to practice. Now go on, play!
Oh, Daddy! George, why must you torture the children? Why don't you...
Mary.
Bedford 247, please.
Is Daddy in trouble?
Yes, Pete. Shall I pray for him? Yes, Janie, pray very hard.
Me too!
You too, Tommy. Hello, Uncle Billy?